All right, everybody, can you hear me? I need your attention. Okay, so I'm Alex Puget. I'm a member of the Cosyne Executive Board, and I want to personally welcome you to Cosyne 2020, which is our 17th edition. So I'm going to be pretty short. I'm here mostly to introduce our program chairs for this year, who are Srdjan Ostojic and Anna-Marie Oswald, who are going to be talking in a couple of minutes. And I want to thank them right away for their job for putting together a fabulous program, but in fact for doing a lot more this year. In fact, they have literally done twice the work that we usually ask from program chairs because they run two review processes in parallel. So if you remember last year, we announced that we're going to experiment with double-blind reviews. So what those guys did is that every abstract this year was single-blind reviewed and double-blind reviewed so that we could compare the effect of the change. Our goal was to see whether double-blind reviews would reduce, if not eliminate, some of the biases that we had seen in our review process, biases that are related to gender, institution, and other factors. So you're about to hear the results of that experiment. Now, before I leave those guys the podium, I want to emphasize one very important point. Since the very beginning with Cosyne, our goal was to deliver a high-quality, selective conference while trying to avoid biases and promote diversity. And we're well aware that this is a tall order. This is hard. So every year, you probably don't know that, but on the Sunday of the meeting, we meet over lunch with all the people who have contributed to the conference, and we discuss new ideas, things, adjustments that we have to make to the conference. And for this process, we really need your help. We need feedback from the community. So if you have ideas on how to improve the conference, don't hesitate to get in touch with us. Don't hesitate to get in touch with members of the executive boards, that would be Zach Mainen, Tony Zador, Stephanie Palmer, or myself, or through the diversity committee, which is chaired this year by Eva Dyer and Eric Shea Brown, or you can also participate to the diversity lunch that takes place on Saturday, which is a great forum to discuss new ideas on how to improve the conference. So please get back to us, help us make this conference better. So with no further ado, I'd like to first ask you to join me and thank Anna-Marie and Srdjan for their fabulous work this year. And the floor is yours.
Thank you very much, Alex. So it's been a great honor and a great pleasure to work with Anne-Marie as a program chair this year. So as Alex said, well, we had to deal with some, to address some very important issues and questions this year. And for this, we teamed up with external experts to assess the gender bias in the selection processes. So in particular, we teamed up with Haruka Uchida, who's a graduate researcher at the Department of Economics at the University of Chicago, specialized in the study of bias and discrimination in selection processes. So Haruka did a huge amount of work for Cosyne. So she analyzed the available data from the two previous years and designed and analyzed the double-blind reviewing procedures for this year. So today we will give you a summary of Haruka's analysis. So first, Haruka looked in detail at the data from 2018 and 2019. Pulling together the data from these 2 years revealed that the acceptance rate for male first authors was significantly greater than for female. And so this is a big issue. It is important to acknowledge that since years, so Cosyne has been very proactive in promoting gender balance at the level of speakers. However, the bias at the overall acceptance rate had largely gone under the radar and needed to be addressed.
Okay, there were a couple ways that we as program chairs wanted to take on this issue of dealing with possible sources of this kind of potential gender bias. And so initially, the very first things that we wanted to do was to make sure that at least the people who were in charge of determining what the scientific content for this meeting was a little bit more balanced and diverse with respect to the program committee and the reviewers. So the first thing that we did was increase the size. Here's a comparison side by side of the gender diversity as well as the scientific diversity of the program committee in 2019 and 2020. This year, 14 members of the program committee rotated off after 5 years of giving their time to Cosyne, and we thank those program committee members a lot for their work. And we added 18 new members to increase the size of the committee. We also increased the percentage of female members of the committee, which we felt was a very important first step. The other aspect of what we did was to increase the scientific diversity. We still covered the four main areas, which really are Cosyne-centric. If you go and look at the keywords, these are kind of the four big keywords that come up at Cosyne. So when we look at the expertise of the program committee, we still cover networks and learning, sensory systems, data and statistics and analysis there, as well as decision and reward. But we've been able to add some more diverse topics and expertise to the program committee, which we hope will diversify the scientific contact of the meeting. And then also in new for this year is we dramatically increased the size of the reviewer pool. And one of the reasons we did this was obviously because every abstract was going to be reviewed by two blinded reviewers and two unblinded reviewers. And so every abstract got reviewed four times. And that's an increase from what it has been in previous years. And so we'd like to thank all the reviewers that came together to help us. A lot of people coming in at the last minute to help us out. The other thing that we also wanted to increase here was also the percentage of female participants in the reviewing process. And I really commend the committee, the program committee, who helps select reviewers.
So, Thank you. Thank you.